Alright, hello everyone and welcome back to Cutabo Space Program, where today we are having a look at the augmented reality docking mod, which was originally made back in the day by forum user Pocket Door. It is now being maintained by none other than Linux Guru Gamer. And what this glorious little piece of fork looks to add into the game is a singular part, which when added to your vessel, will add some very helpful in-flight visual indicators to assist in your docking. And I love this thing, as it's very useful for people like myself who aren't the greatest of pilots with, say, things like, well, docking procedures. So let's jump into the vehicle assembly building and have a look at that one part. Now let's grab the Mark 1 command pod for size comparison's sake and then head down to the utility category where we have the augmented reality docking assistant. Now it isn't exactly the most beautiful of parts we've ever seen on this channel, but that's not the point. It's the purpose that makes it so wonderful, as once it is attached to your vessel, it will give you that augmented reality display. And of course, you can always hide it by, say, moving or rotating it inside your vessel, so hey, no harm, no foul. Now let's go over to the tracking station and go to some ships I have in orbit to actually show off how this augmented reality display does work. So let's just jump up to my AR docking vessel, and let's go ahead and decouple these ships from one another, and then back off a bit to give ourselves some distance. And it's pretty simple to activate this mod. All you need to do is target another vessel. And there we go. Now, besides just having the usual target icon here with the distance, we now also do have a couple of arrows. The first one is showing us our line to our target, and that on its own would actually be a very useful thing to have, as it does give us a more easily visible indicator of where we need to get to, especially on more complex space stations you're trying to dock with. Now beyond this white arrow, we have a couple of others. We have a small blue arrow here and two yellow arrows here. Now the yellow arrows are showing us our relative direction and speed in relation to the target. So if we moved off to the left, this arrow here would get larger, showing us that yeah, we're moving to the left of the target. And same with the bottom arrow here. If we moved down, that arrow would get bigger, showing us we are moving lower. Now the blue arrow is showing us what direction we need to go to course correct to actually get in line with the target. And currently you can see we are actually kind of moving not just backwards but also to the left of the target. That's why that arrow is a bit bigger than say the blue arrow over here. That's because we are moving off to the left. Now you will also notice it is kind of in a bit of an awkward position, and that's for two reasons. One, we are currently controlling it from the command pod, so it's a bit further back in the vessel. And we can change that by, say, right-clicking on the Clampatron Jr. here and controlling from here. And notice, say, this bottom arrow here, since that's more easily visible. And once we hit control from here, it moves forward. And that's a very useful thing to have. So say if you do have your docking port off to the side and you control from there, the arrows will move appropriately over to there, showing you the corrections needed with that docking port being to the side. It's very, very useful to be able to have those arrows change. Now, the other reason why it is a bit far back in the ship even still is because, like with the direction arrow off here to the side and down here to the bottom, there is also another direction arrow, and we are currently moving backwards away from the target. So say if we moved forward, well, there you go, the arrow, we have a new arrow that shows itself, now showing that we are moving towards the targeted vessel. And if we move backwards again, you can see it goes back into the ship once more, showing us we are reversing away from it. So those alone are very useful things. So the yellow showing us our direction of travel, and the blue showing us where we need to go, and the white just kind of pointing us to our target. Now, a couple of interesting things that we'll notice. Now, currently, we are still moving off to the left, and if we say move more to the left, you can see that arrow changing because, yeah, we're getting more and more off course in that direction, and so the blue is really wanting us to go to the right. And if we do course correct over to the right, you can notice that that blue disappeared, and that bit of yellow is now white. And that's because, well, we are moving off to the right now, but if we don't course correct back to the left, then we're actually going to, you know, go off to the other side of the targeted vessel. So that white is showing us that we actually do need to course correct a bit more to the left. And basically what you want is sort of this view where there is no blue and none of the yellow bits are actually showing us that we are, you know, or white showing us that we need to course correct back that way, and that we do want this to sort of change color to the yellow here. This is showing us that we are actually pretty nicely on path for going to that target right now, which I'm actually surprised by. That is impressive. We are coming in at an angle and we will hit it pretty well. But if we'd go even a little bit off, there it goes back to white, and it's showing we need to course correct back to the left. And yeah, that is how to use the augmented reality docking revived mod. It is very handy to have these things, and I do love that blue arrow. It's not just, of course, showing left or right. You can see it is angling up or down here as we go, you know, up and down from the target. And you're just wanting to align these all up so that you do eventually make that be yellow, which we actually had there for a moment, surprisingly. But yeah, it's just a very handy, useful tool to assist you in your docking procedures. And, you know, does give you a lot of valuable information that I find personally very helpful. So if you want to have a look at this mod for yourself, which I would certainly recommend you go and do, you can have a look at the link in the description as per usual. But that is going to be it for this episode today, my friends. I hope you all have enjoyed and that you do come back for the next. But until that time, thank you for watching. And as always, have a good one!